So the question is now, so how many tabs do we actually need for our FRA filter? Obviously, the less computational effort there is. And to answer this question here, the answer lies in the DFT, or the simplest way of finding this. The answer is, let's have a look at the DFT. So the DFT, so remember, if we have an FIR filter of m tabs, then this means after we've done the DFT, we've got m frequency coefficients. So that's so if we have here our frequency coefficients, and that's our IDFT. So it's an inverse discrete Fourier transform, and these here are m coefficients, then we're getting again m tabs out here. So that's on both sides m. And so this means that, so if we draw our discrete Fourier spectrum here, so that starts from zero and goes to m minus one. So these are our frequency indices here. Then this corresponds here to 0 hertz. And the midpoint here, m half, corresponds to fs half. And then we know that m corresponds to fs. So therefore that's linear mapping here, which runs from 0 to fs between 0 and m. So m is somewhere here. So that's our frequency index here. And so this means that if we think of the index number one here, so that's index number one, then the question is, so which frequency is this here? So if we have here index number zero and there's index number one, so which delta f does that represent? And that's obviously very easy. So delta f is then, if you know that the whole axis is fs, then we just divide this by the number of tabs. Sampling rate, number of tabs. Number of tabs. Let's do the p here properly. So this gives us then the number of tabs gives us the frequency resolution. Frequency resolution. I'll write this out on the next slide here again. So if we have m tabs, we are getting delta f resolution. So simple as that. So therefore, if we design a certain filter with a certain transition width, we need to be careful that this is within these boundaries. So let's just write this. So delta f divided fs divided by m is our frequency resolution. So it can't get better. Now the thing is that this still means this is the best case scenario. Yeah, so let's think of a frequency response. So therefore, if you have zero here, m minus one, that's an x of k, and that's our index k. So let's imagine we have a high pass filter. So that's a one here, and we have the we want to have a high pass filter with a very, very low behavior. So basically, just a high pass filter removing the DC. High pass removing DC. Remember, a DC has no mirror, so this goes up to m minus one. So then the question is, so what is the frequency resolution here? So therefore, that's our theoretical resolution of our filter here. So that's what's the lowest frequency is possible for this high pass filter. For this high pass. So let's do an example to make this easier to understand. So let's say we have a 1000 tap filter. So M is 1000. Sampling rate is 1 kilohertz. And so when we just take this formula up there, so delta F equals to 1 kilohertz divided by 1000, and this gives us 1 hertz. So that's in our resolution is 1 hertz. So the best what this filter could do here is filter out anything below 1 hertz. So now imagine we are increasing our number of taps. 1 kilohertz, then obviously our delta F is now 0.5 hertz. But remember, this is all theory. So how is that practically? So theory is delta F is if S divided by M. Let's draw again here our high pass filter with our 0 and 1. So this goes to M minus 1 K X of K. Yeah, so we know that if we are doing now the IFFT of that and getting our impulse response. That the actual filter has no longer the ideal response, but is smoothed out. So what we are probably getting out there is maybe something like that. Well, let's don't be so brutal, but let's say so that's our response here, m minus one. So because we have a finite transition width here. And so this is then actually what in practice comes out there. And so therefore in practice we need to have much more maybe twice as many or three times as many taps to get a proper response if you want to have a very narrow response. So therefore in practice this means we need more taps to take into account the transition width.